Scott Hudson, Mike Tenay back in a jam-packed arena here on Worldwide as Judo Suwa makes his return to WCW. And Mike, we talked about the international scope of World Championship Wrestling, and we do mean the world. Judo Suwa, a native of the Land of the Rising Sun, Japan, trained in Mexico.
Well, it was an effort on the part of Judo Suwa and several other young wrestlers from Tokyo, Japan, to emulate their hero, the Ultimo Dragon, a former WCW World's Cruiserweight Champion. So this group of Japanese wrestlers moved from Tokyo, Japan to Mexico City. And over the course of the past year and a half, they have been training at an arena just outside of Mexico City called Arena Naucalpan. That is owned basically by the family of Ultimo Dragon. They promote live wrestling events there on a weekly basis. And Judo Suwa has been gaining a vast amount of experience in Mexico. And recently, he has even returned to his homeland where Ultimo Dragon is promoting wrestling events in Japan. And Judo Suwa now returns to the United States with World Championship Wrestling to face another international star in Vampiro.
Vampiro, a native of Canada, also went south of the border to Mexico City to train as a luchador, where he achieved a great measure of success.
Well, it's very interesting because he originally trained for wrestling in the Toronto area. From there, his career really took off, however, when he did go to Mexico, and he spent the better part of the last 6 or 7 years as one of the top headlining wrestlers all throughout the country of Mexico.
Very interesting. Two men who inarguably are luchadors, neither of whom are natives of Mexico.
Oh, standing back kick right in the jaw on Judo Suwa.
Extensive martial arts background as well for Vampiro, and he certainly used it that time as he flattened Judo Suwa with the kick.
Now Vampiro putting the boot to Suwa in the corner. Third man in the ring, referee Nick Patrick, may have a hard time maintaining control here. Headbutt from Vampiro drops Suwa. Boot right into the back from Vampiro.
Now the obvious size and power advantage on the part of Vampiro. Judo Suwa is going to need to have more of a hit and run type offense. So far he's just been on the receiving end.
Oh, what a chop from Vampiro. Boy, I tell you, that sounds like one thing on television, but here live in the arena, that is an impressive noise from that chop. Hang on, reversal. Vampiro, no, tucked out of the way of the back elbow. Missed the clothesline.
Boom! Drove him down to the canvas with that variation of the uranage.
And Vampiro getting the crowd into it in the worldwide arena.
Well, I'm surprised that Judo Suwa has decided to fight it out on the mat with Vampiro. I would think that he would go to a more high-risk offense, and he instead goes for the double leg takedown.
Now Suwa takes it outside to the ring apron. Springboard up into the clothesline. Knocked him for a loop, and Vampiro's down.
Turned him inside out. Springboard into the lariat. And that's more of what we expected from the smaller Judo Suwa. Don't fight it out on the mat with Vampiro. Go to the top rope when you have the chance.
Double leg, catapult into the middle steel cable.
Well, there the size of Vampiro precluded that catapult from having much effect.
But you see Judo Suwa, all of his body weight across the top of the back of Vampiro, and Vampiro still cannot get on track. Suwa helps him back to his feet. Full slam coming up in the center of the ring from Suwa.
Well, impressive on the part of Judo Suwa that he was able to lift up the 250-pound Vampiro without much effort. High-risk move, but ooh, Vamp is ready.
I mean, Vampiro cut him off in the corner. Vampiro with Suwa seated on the top turnbuckle, now up top. Whoa! Release belly-to-belly suplex from Vampiro, and Suwa went all the way across the ring.
Well, it was part suplex and part throw, and now he hooks on the submission hold. Look at the pressure on the ankle, the twisting on the knee as well, and referee Nick Patrick goes down not only to count the shoulders of Judo Suwa, but also see if he's going to tap out. But Vampiro releases the hold and comes up and connects with a boot to the midsection.
Oh! Spinning front kick nails Suwa. Lateral press. Keys it in, and that will do it.
Nicely done. Combination of the pinfall attempt as well as that hammer lock, a rather tough wrist lock at the same time that he keyed through, and Vampiro is in the winner's circle.
I tell you what, that was action-packed as Vampiro bask in the glory here in the Worldwide Arena. It is going to be worth one more look. Good luck picking out some highlights of this one. It was all highlights. It's our 10-10-3-2-1 replay here on Worldwide. 10-10-3-2-1. Dial it and save 50% on calls over 10 minutes.
Now, probably the best offensive move from Judo Suwa was that springboard lariat. Here's the combination, suplex and throw from Vampiro off the top rope. He connected with a tremendous spinning roundhouse kick, the cover, the eventual three count, and Vampiro gains the victory.
An impressive victory for an impressive athlete. For Mike today, I'm Scott Hudson. Let's send it back inside to Tony and Larry.
All right, guys, thanks a lot. Before we get out of town this week, fans, a reminder of the Great American Bash. 1 week from this Sunday, World Tag Team Title Champions Raven and Saturn against Diamond Dallas Page and Bam Bam Bigelow. Bigelow and Page given the title shot by Ric Flair, and that has caused a split within the Four Horsemen.
Well, you know, definitely the last straw on the back of Malenko and Benoit. They've got to be upset. But, you know, what is going through the mind of Ric Flair? China knows more about our nuclear defense system than we'll ever know about the backroom politics. You know, why did he not give the shot to the Horsemen when they rightfully deserve it?
You know, I just thought of something. We've gone the whole program without you talking about your golf game. That's a...
You know, actually, I hit so many balls, I've got calluses on my calluses, so I've got to take a couple days off.
And we still don't care. For the living legend, Larry
Zbyszko. Man, am I hitting them.
I bet you are. I'm Tony Schiavone. See you next week on Worldwide Wrestling.